It is my absolute pleasure to welcome all of you to the Gourmet Extravaganza, a massive, massive mod for Solo Don't Starve and all of its expansions. Heck, even the non-Reign of Giants experience is gonna get some love at the end of the day. Brought to us by two very familiar faces in Mathem 99 and Default, along with some help behind the scenes, of course. Gourmet Extravaganza here might appear to be all about the foodies and foodies alone, but oh no. There are some big-time mechanic tweaks hidden in the mix as well, folks. From 73 new recipes, 1,500 lines of new character dialogue, new mob loot, and more, all I can say is let's feast. Well, not quite yet, actually. For you see, to gain the whole benefit of Gourmet Extravaganza, your first stop should be its configuration menu. By default, the Elephant Cactus flower setting is disabled, so if you are wanting all of them new loot drops, you best enable it before setting sail. But as always, feel free to mess with whatever settings you please, from enabling the ability to cook character-exclusive recipes to disabling entire recipe selections whenever you please. Eat your way. But let's get started here with some very familiar crops in a not-so-familiar place. Yes, everyone. Onions, garlic, toma roots, and peppers have popped up from the soils of Solo Don't Starve and are ready to go into many of the recipes to follow here in part 1 and part 2. As yes, this mod is way too big for just one sitting. But expect some very similar stats from them. But don't forget the newest crop either, in wheat. For you see, wheat is going to help us acquire one of the three newest ingredients in the game too, in flour. A bag of flour to be exact. Three wheat and one rock will net you a single bag, so make notes. But what are the other two ingredients added, you ask? Well, corn syrup, of course, and chili powder from Don't Starve Together. One corn and three honey and or sweeteners, mind you, will net one corn syrup that cannot be eaten straight up and will spoil over time. So you best be ready to use it, if you know what I mean. But since chili powder here is now no longer a Warly exclusive, we can expect it to be an alchemy refinement instead of a food-related craft. Two peppers, two normal seeds, and some niter will net two chili powders for your trouble. So there you go, folks, the three new ingredients. Oh, but we are just getting started on the new stuff, everyone, so don't you worry. Remember that elephant cactus flower I mentioned? Yeah, it comes from elephant cacti, of course, from within Don't Starve Shipwrecked, and has a 33% chance to drop at the end of the day. Now alone, it will knock us for 10 health a munch while restoring 8 hunger. But combined two of the suckers with two seaweed and one poison gland and a medicated cactus balm will be yours. It is a new healing item that will restore 40 health a pop, but will spoil in roughly 7.5 days. So be mindful there. But man, elephant cacti just got somehow even better. But next comes something sweeter, perhaps, literally in this case. With this mod, we can get some Royal Womat Jelly, everyone. All mat types offer a whopping 2% chance at dropping one, which is obviously not ideal. So you will be better off killing the Queen Womat here for a chance at 8 jelly drops at once, with definitely a few guaranteed at least. Now alone, the Royal Womat Jelly already restores quite a bit of hunger, sanity, and health as you can see. But what is jelly in these games without some jelly beans? With Royal Womat Jelly, we can make green jelly beans for sanity overtime gains, yellow for hunger overtime regen, and red for the usual health overtime that we see with regular jelly beans and Don't Starve Together. But it's sweet stuff all around. But is anyone else already getting quite thirsty from all this talking? If so, then perhaps the newest drop from the Bramble Blooms of Don't Starve Hamlet's Lush Season will do for you. They now drop Bramble Bloom Blossoms that alone don't do much as you can see, but once in a crock pot with some lotus flower and honey will turn into slimming blossom tea. It will restore 26 sanity and 4 health, lower our temperatures by 5 instantly, delay sneezing by 2 minutes. However, when consumed, expect even more sanity over time, up to an additional 50 points, but at the cost of hunger, mind you. A significant amount at that, actually. Still, it's neat, and now I understand why it's bloody named that at the end of the day. Ah, but here's a change that I can truly get behind. Giant grubs actually dropping something, and actually being relevant because of that. Giant grubs, found in the Mant Hills, will now drop giant grub tails, as well as chitin occasionally. However, today is all about the food, so who bloody cares about that? Uncooked though, giant grub tails will restore 26 hunger and 5 health, while hitting us for 13 sanity a munch. But when cooked, grub will remove any of that sanity hit, while offering 33 hunger and 11 health now. See? I knew eating bugs was good. Plants too, especially ones that drop meat to boots. With this mod, Snaptoots of all kinds will now have a chance to drop a leafy morsel on top of leafy meats. Smaller Snaptoots offer us an 85% chance at morsels, while the big boys will give us a 70% chance instead. Now this does mean that leafy meat might be a bit harder to come by at the end of the day, but hey, leafy morsels ain't that bad. Especially when cooked. Great? No, but they will come in handy later. Just not today, mind you. Today was about the new crops, ingredients, drops, and now some of the new recipes that we have for Don't Starve Hamlet specifically. Cause otherwise, we would have been here all day. And I don't mean to bug you, cause that's what buggy panettone is for. Bean bugs, flour, and fruits will offer us 90 hunger, 40 health, but also minus 15 sanity, so be mindful there. But see? Bugs are great. So is not dying from poisonous food during its off season, like with Blooming Tuber and its newest recipe, Blooming Tuber Casserole. All tubers all the time, for 42.5 hunger, a whopping 0 sanity, but 50 health restored. Not bad. Use 2 of our newest ingredients in corn syrup and flour alongside some berries to whip up some berry tarts if you wish. 25 hunger, 33 sanity, 30 health, and it's gonna stop us from sneezing for a while. So I say that's some sweet relief. But lastly, wrapped lotus flower is next. And with a fly trap stalk and, well, lotus flowers, we can enjoy 18.75 hunger, 10 sanity, 3 health, and a whopping 7 minutes of no sneezing to boots. But to actually wrap up here today, let's actually get into some of Warly's newest recipes that can be configured to not actually be Warly exclusive, mind you. But cheesecake is first, and at the cost of corn syrup, flour, electric milk, and fruits, one can enjoy 42.5 hunger, 50 sanity, and a solid 100 health restored. So eat up. Oh, here's a fun one. Crabbit cake. Catch a live crabbit off the beaches of Don't Starve Shipwrecked and toss it together with roe and veggies for 75 hunger, 33 sanity, and 8 health each crabby bites. Good stuff. Creamy fish is next and sounds both delicious yet disgusting at the same time, but toss together fish and milk for 25 hunger, 33 sanity, and 30 health a bite. A slurp, a spoonful, I don't freaking know what the consistency of this thing is, but what I do know is that I'll take it. And finally, jelly rolls. Simply requiring 2 berries and 2 honey as you can see. A jelly roll will restore 22.5 hunger, 20 sanity, and 3 health. Both each. Easy peasy. Ah, but we ain't quite done yet, actually. For you see, a few of Warly's Don't Starve Together meals have also made it in too, like his Glowberry Mousse and its ability to provide light when consumed, his Moqueca and its high hunger and health regens. Now we'll also be requiring 2 of the quote-unquote new crops, as you can see. And lastly, his Bone Bouillon and its 150 hunger, 5 sanity, and 32 health to slurp. Great stuff. And before we go, here's an idea of the craziness yet to come. Not only have we only covered 15 or so of the 73 total recipes in this mod, everything that you see in my inventory and backpack here has now been made quote-unquote edible, meaning that the remaining dishes are about to get weird. So I'll see you for them soon. So, There you have it, everyone. Part one of the incredible gourmet extravaganza mod by Mathem99, Default, and the rest of the team. Now we've got plenty more to see in part two, so I hope to see you there soon. Thanks for watching, folks. Well wishes to all. Save room for seconds, thirds, fourths, and desserts. And I'll see ya in the next one. Bye-bye.